100% sure, but there's some good stuff to be looking forward to, some good content coming out, and we got some NBX surprises too. Awesome NBX surprise, you guys. Stay tuned. Awesome stuff coming up on the EXO channels, especially on the main channel. So be sure to click like. Always really appreciate those thumbs up, guys. Share this video on your Facebook wall with your friends if you think anybody would enjoy it. And thank you guys for sticking with me all this time. I will see you on the next video.
You know what time it is, YouTube.
Alright, what's going on, guys?
Garbage can.
There we go. Alright, what's going on, guys? Doing my first tutorial video on amplifiers. Here it is, amplifiers. Let's move all these papers here. Alright, since I only have like I only have like four thumbtacks, I think we're just gonna leave it like that. So what we're doing today is amps, like I just said. So what does an amplifier do? It amplifies, like amperage, not voltage. It amplifies the signal coming from your head unit and puts them into your speakers or subwoofers. So basically, what the signal is a sine wave. Well, generally, what we want in a subwoofer application is a sine wave. So I'm gonna draw a sine wave here. So this is 0 dB. So we'll label it 0 dB. Bad spelling. All right, so this is 0. Also, it's also gonna be 0 volts. So 0 voltage coming out of the amp. And then let's see here. This is gonna be our sine wave. We'll do that in red. So there we go. That's our signal coming out of the amplifier from the head unit. So what that's doing is it's bringing the small sine wave to a bigger sine wave, higher voltage, higher amperage, more wattage output. So let's see. What are the different features amplifiers have? They have gain is the big one. Gain, low pass, LP, subsonic, SS, bass boost. Oops, I'm dropping stuff. Bass boost, phase, I'm not really sure what that one is. Phase, and, there's always a couple other of them, like, strapping, so I'll just put link right there. And then there's like lights, protect lights. I'm sure I'm leaving something out, but those are the main ones that we really need to know, mainly being the top three here. So the gain. How do you set a gain? What is a gain? That's the really big main topic here. Setting the gain. The gain is basically a way to match the output of your head unit and match the output of your amplifier. So your head unit puts out a clean signal at a certain volume and lower. Above the certain volume means that it's generally going to be clipped or distorted or changed in some way, mainly being clipping. So we need to find that maximum volume or go below it, and then not turn it up past that, and then we also need to set our gain so that our amp is not doing the same thing. It's not clipping or it's not distorting or changing the signal in any way and before it goes out to your subwoofers or speakers. So say we have here, we have our RCA line, and we have a matching signal going into the amp. So this one's smaller. I drew it with black. So it's smaller. It's coming from the head unit to the amp, and then it's coming bigger. It's been amplified. More amperage is going through. So we have a clean signal going in, and we have our gain set below the clipping or distortion level. So we have, you know, no clipping here. So if we did have that above the clipping or distortion level, it would be imaginary line, say approximately right here. So right here, this line here is zero. That's zero output, zero decibels, and zero voltage. So we need to find the maximum output voltage, the maximum clean output voltage of our amplifier, and you can use that, use this chart right here that you're seeing on the screen, or at least I hope you're seeing on the screen, and you can use that chart to find the voltage that you need with your ohms and your wattage output. And then, so what you're going to do is you're going to hook up a multimeter, a digital multimeter, hook up the probes on the leads, the output leads on the amplifier, negative and positive on the speaker outputs, and then you're going to measure the voltage. So you want to measure AC voltage. So if you need to turn the gain up until the voltage matches this imaginary line here. So if we went above that voltage like that, it would be distorted, it would be clipped off like that. So if we went even farther above it, I drew on the corkboard, then it'd be even more distorted. So it'd basically be like you can't go above this dotted line here, but you can still keep cranking the gain up and making it worse. So if we went even more, then it'd basically just be like that. It'd just be a square wave. No clean signals is going to be played to your subwoofers or speakers. That's really bad. This line right here, that's essentially just a DC pulse. So this would be, this one's down, so it's point. So it'd be DC negative pulse. Is just taking your woofer cone, moving it out, and holding it there for a period of time, and then it's coming back in. And then it's doing the same thing. It would be pushing it out, holding it there for a certain amount of time, and then coming back down. Pushing it out, holding it there for a certain amount of time, and then pushing it back in. So you can see we have these heavy clip marks right here. See, all those right there. Those are all going to be adding heat and adding audible distortion. Some people say just clipping is not audible. Yes, it is. It's not always the most apparent, but it is. So all these marks right here, those are just adding heat, adding distortion. It's not good. You're just going to cook your voice coil and stuff like that. Yeah, you can't turn your gain up past this output voltage here. So it's just a way, the turning up the gain is a way to match the output of the head unit to match the output of your amplifier. So moving on to the other topics here, the filters, low pass and subsonic filters. Let's see here. Well, low pass, it's essentially just a filter. It's filtering out all the voice and the mid-bass and the treble and all that stuff. It's filtering out, all the higher frequencies and just playing the lows. So we say we have our signal here, and it has mid-bass and voice. So it's not going to be just a sine wave like this. It's also going to have extra stuff in there. It's going to be all furry like that. And then what's it going to do once it comes into the amp? That low pass is maybe it is. So it's just the bass, just the lower frequencies. So then music also has subsonics. If it's produced not very well. Very common nowadays in electronic music. So you're also going to have subsonics, which are not good, if you don't want them. So see, this frequency right here is one of them, and then we're going to have, say, a lower frequency like that. So you can see how that's totally going against the grain with this higher frequency. So that subsonic is going to filter out this lower frequency here, this longer, lower frequency. So then it comes through, and it is just this one right here. Bass boost is generally at 40 hertz. It's pretty much all it's doing is just boosting a band at 40 hertz like that. Generally, it is going to add distortion. It's generally recommended to just not even use it. Just turn it all the way down and just forget about it. phase, that's, I'm not 100% sure what the degrees in are in between 0 and 180. But basically, it would be like flipping the speaker leads. So if you have one here, or one woofer here, and one inverted here, just mainly for looks, then you could say set this amp regular, and then set this amp with the phase at 180 if you didn't feel like switching the speaker leads. And then linking and strapping. Linking and strapping, it's just basically a way of putting two amplifiers into one. Everything doubles. So you have two amplifiers, and then you're doubling up the ohm load, so it's stable from 1 ohm to 2 ohms now, and your wattage is doubled, so you have, you know, double the RMS power. So I'll review that one more time. Everything is doubled. Your minimum ohm load is doubled, your amount of amplifiers is doubled, and your amount of wattage is doubled. And then finishing up lights and stuff, protect lights and on and off lights. Usually it's generally a blue or green for on, and then just a red one for protect. That's really it for lights. There's not really much to talk about. Alright, well, there's nothing I can really think about right now, so if you have any questions, leave them down in the comments section below, and thanks for watching.